Nasal polyps are noncancerous growths that develop in the lining of the nose and paranasal sinuses, the air-filled spaces that are connected to the nasal cavity. They are typically soft, painless, and have a teardrop or grape-like shape. While small nasal polyps may not cause symptoms, larger growths or groups of polyps can block the nasal passages or lead to breathing problems, a reduced sense of smell, and frequent infections. This video covers the medical definition and provides a brief overview of this topic. So if you're ready, let's get into it. The exact cause of nasal polyps is not fully understood, but they are often associated with chronic inflammation and are commonly found in conditions such as chronic sinusitis, asthma, allergic rhinitis, and cystic fibrosis. Certain immune system responses and chemical markers in the mucous membrane of the nasal passages also appear to play a role in the development of nasal polyps. It's noteworthy that nasal polyps are not related to cancer and are usually benign. Symptoms of nasal polyps include a persistent stuffy or blocked nose, runny nose, postnasal drip, decreased or absent sense of smell, facial pain or headache, pressure over the forehead and face, and snoring. In some cases, individuals may also experience a sense of pressure over their forehead and face. When polyps block the drainage from the sinuses, they can lead to recurrent infections and complications such as sinusitis. The diagnosis of nasal polyps typically involves a physical examination, which includes looking into the nasal passages. A doctor may use a lighted instrument called an endoscope to examine the nasal passages and sinuses more closely. Imaging studies such as CT scans can also help to determine the size and location of the polyps, as well as to evaluate the sinuses for signs of inflammation or infection. Treatment for nasal polyps usually starts with medications, which can help shrink or even eliminate nasal polyps in some cases. Corticosteroids, which can be administered as a nasal spray, oral medication, or injection, are often the first-line treatment. These help to reduce inflammation and the size of the polyps. Other medications may include antihistamines, antibiotics, and medications to treat any underlying conditions such as asthma or allergies. In cases where medication is ineffective or polyps are particularly large or cause significant symptoms, surgery might be necessary. The most common procedure is called endoscopic sinus surgery, which involves using a small camera and instruments to remove the polyps while preserving as much of the surrounding tissue as possible. However, even after successful treatment, nasal polyps often recur, which may necessitate ongoing medical therapy or repeated surgeries. Lastly, managing underlying conditions that contribute to inflammation in the nasal passages and sinuses can help prevent the recurrence of nasal polyps. This might involve ongoing treatment for asthma or allergies, for instance. Also, practicing good nasal hygiene, such as using a saline nasal rinse, can help to keep the nasal passages clear and reduce the risk of inflammation and polyp development. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. There should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.